In today's Satori Graphics tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this Adobe Illustrator glow effect. Remember to subscribe if you're new to my channel, and to move to the timestamp in the corner if you want to skip the intro. Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. Today we're going to be working on a glow effect tutorial in Adobe Illustrator. I saw a design similar to this on Instagram, so I don't claim this design as mine. I'm simply here showing you guys how to make a design in this style. Today we're going to be working on A3 canvas in a portrait style. We're going to make a background first for our glow effect design. So take the rectangle tool and click and drag to make a rectangle across the entire canvas. We then need to add our gradient fill like so. I have presets for you all to set up your gradient. Firstly, it must be a radial gradient, and then change the aspect ratio to 130 degrees. In the first color on the left, double click it and then select CMYK in the top right corner. Then add CMYK values of 100, 85, 5 and 0. In the second color section, type in 100, 100, 25 and 81. Lastly, pull the location slider down to around 45. This would be our background in Adobe Illustrator for the glow effect tutorial. But lastly, lock it in place so it doesn't move around. Now we need a triangle for our glow effect design, so go ahead and grab the polygon tool from the toolbar and then select a stroke in the color palette. Then double click the canvas and in the pop-up window type in 3 sides and then hit OK. Holding down the Shift and Alt Option key at the same time, click and drag to resize it. Then by holding just the Alt Option key until you see this icon appear, click and drag to duplicate the triangle. We will need this copy later in the Adobe Illustrator tutorial. With the original triangle, change the stroke weight to something thick as we need a good strong shape for our glow effect design. If you want to resize the triangle, you must resize both of them at the same time because they need to be the same size. So hold down Shift and select both of them and then resize. With the main triangle, go up to Object and Outline Stroke, which will convert the stroke into a shape. Now with the pen tool, we're going to cut out a part of the triangle quite easily. So carefully draw a line like I'm doing here and connect the path, and then click both shapes by holding down Shift. We need the Pathfinder window open, and then select the minus front option. We can now take the direct selection tool and tidy up the cut that we've just made, as well as move the anchor points over a bit. Your design should look something similar to mine here at this point in today's Illustrator glow effect tutorial. Change the shape fill color to a shade of blue slightly lighter than the background. Take the copy triangle and bring it over to the front of all the objects and then place it in the correct position. This is where we need to take the scissors tool to cut out a piece in the bottom left and then delete it. I'm going to lower the stroke weight on the line as well. Select the thin line and lock it in place so it doesn't move around. We're now going to draw a white line from the top point to the very top of the design. Add this stroke style here to the line so it goes from thick to thin. You can lower the stroke weight if you want to, but go ahead and add these lines anywhere on your design you think fits. So here's my design at the moment. Now click over everything and lock it in place. We're going to add a glow effect now to the design by using blur effects and the transparency window. Choose a very light blue color in the color palette, and with the pen tool, draw a line like I'm doing here. Boost the stroke weight up to something like 20, and add this stroke style here. You can also use the width tool to adjust the thickness of the line anywhere along the path. But for me personally, I'm going to keep it just as it is. But the width tool is there if you want to use it. With the line selected, choose Add Gaussian Blur and then click Preview to see before you hit OK. You can lower the opacity in the effects window so it's not so striking. Using the Alt Option key, you can duplicate the line and then reposition it with the Direct Selection tool. Go ahead and add this effect anywhere along your design that you see fit. So now we're going to add a glow effect to our design, but this time using colored glow effects. As before, lock everything in place beforehand. I'm going to use a purple pink kind of hue that I think will look great with this design. There are many ways to do this, but I'm going to use the ellipse tool to create a shape. Then with the Direct Selection tool, we will move the anchor points and manipulate it into place. Then open up the transparency window, and you can play around with the blend mode settings. The settings that work best are overlay, soft light, hard light, and color dodge, but you can experiment to see what looks best. Keep using the Direct Selection tool to arrange the shape of your glow effect design in today's tutorial. Go ahead and add shapes like this all over your design using various colors and styles. We have one last effect to add to our design today. Unlock everything and then lock the background layer only. You can resize the triangle, but be careful because the glow blur effect may become distorted if you resize it too greatly. Select the light blue triangle only and add outer glow. We'll be using a black color, and then the blend mode should be normal. Again, play around the settings and use the preview option. And there you have it, a glow effect design in Adobe Illustrator. Adding some text beneath looks pretty cool as well. So let me know if you enjoyed today's glow effect tutorial brought to you by Satori Graphics. Subscribe for 4 weekly graphic design uploads, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.